Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss some numerical problem on nuclear basic properties like nuclear size. We have already discussed some problems in the previous videos, so let's start the video. The question is, an oxygen nucleus is spherical and has a charge radius capital R and a volume V equal 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now according to empirical observation, empirical means anuman ke aadhar par observation, ya experimental observation ko hum empirical observation bol sakte hain, ye exact koi formula nahi hota, of the charge radii, the volume of the xenon 128 nucleus assumed to be spherical is what? 8 times volume, 2 times volume or 6.75 times volume or 1.89 times volume. So we have already known that the formula of radius, that is R proportional to e to the power 1 by 3, and given is V equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. This now for oxygen, we can write as R radius of oxygen proportional to A means 16 to the power 1 by 3. And similarly for xenon, is proportional to 128 to the power 1 by 3. So substituting this is, suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. On dividing equation 1 by 2, we get R oxygen upon R xenon. So this is equal to 16 upon 128 to the power 1 by 3, and this gives 1 upon 8. Now for volume ratio, so for oxygen equal to 4 by 3 pi r oxygen q, and for xenon volume equal 4 by 3 pi r xenon q. So V of Xz upon V naught is equal to R xenon cube upon R oxygen cube. So from this equation, so this is equal to 1 by 3 power. So if we cube both sides of this equation, we get this is equal to 1 by 8. Sorry, 8 upon 1. It is 8 ratio 1. So V of xenon is equal to 8 times V of oxygen. So this is the result. So the first option is correct, 8 times volume. Clear? Now the next question, which is very important, asking in 2016 GEST exam, and which is, if the Rydberg constant of an atom of finite nuclear mass is alpha times R infinite, where alpha R infinite is the Rydberg constant corresponding to an infinite nuclear mass. तो इनफाइनाइट न्यूक्लियर मास के लिए जो रिडबर्ग कांस्टेंट है वो आर इनफाइनाइट है. सो हमें फाइंड करना है, फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टू द न्यूक्लियर मास ऑफ द एटम. सो क्वेश्चन है, इफ द रिडबर्ग कांस्टेंट ऑफ एन एटम, किसी एटम के लिए रिडबर्ग कांस्टेंट उस एटम के फाइनाइट न्यूक्लियर मास के लिए अल्फा टाइम्स आर इनफाइनाइट है, तो रेशियो क्या होगा इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टू न्यूक्लियर मास ऑफ द एटम. सो फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज 1 माइनस अल्फा अपॉन अल्फा, अल्फा माइनस 1 अपॉन अल्फा, या 1 माइनस अल्फा, या 1 अपॉन अल्फा. सो वी नो दैट द रिडबर्ग कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर एन एटम हैविंग एन इनफाइनाइटली हैवी न्यूक्लियस इज आर इनफाइनाइट इज इक्वल टू एम ई टू द पावर 4 8 epsilon naught square h cube c. Suppose this is question first, and for an atom having nuclear mass capital M is R m equal to mu e power 4 upon 8 epsilon square h cube to c. Suppose this is equation 2, where mu is equal to m upon m plus m. So where the small m is the mass of electron and capital M is the mass of nucleus. So from mu equal to mm upon m plus m, we can write as m upon 1 plus m by m, simply divided by capital M. So R of m becomes m e power 4 8 epsilon 0 square h cube c into 1 upon simply putting the value of mu in this equation 2. So 1 upon 1 plus m upon capital M. And this is nothing but is R infinite 1 plus M upon capital M. So suppose this is equation third. Now according to question, we have already Rm is equal to alpha times R infinite. So this is equal to, so if we substitute this value, R of m equal to n infinite upon 1 plus m by m. From this equation here, R infinite upon 1 plus m upon n is equal to alpha R infinite. So this is cancel. We get 1 plus m upon m is equal to 1 by alpha. So m by m is equal to 1 by alpha minus 1, and this is equal 1 minus alpha upon alpha. So this is the electronic mass and this is the nuclear mass. So we get the final ratio as electronic mass and nuclear mass, and this is equal to 1 minus alpha upon alpha. So the correct option is 1 minus alpha upon alpha. So this is all about for today. Thanks for watching video. Thank you.